Does the fear of rain, lightning, and glaciers keep you inside next to your cute little kitty cat?
Well, you can be better prepared for the outdoors with weather tips
from Weather Nerds.
Now, pretend this coffee cup is a mountain range. The way Foehn winds work is air coming from this direction wants to pass through the mountains, but it can't do that because the mountains are immovable. Now, so this air, what happens is it has to move over the top of the mountains. When this occurs on this side of the mountain range, the air rises and cools, and it's forced to release some of its moisture as rainfall. Now, as the air moves over to the other side of the mountains, the exact opposite effect occurs. Now here, the same air is forced downward. When the air is forced downward on this side of the coffee cup, or in this case, our mountain range, it warms up and it also dries out. Here in New Zealand, this effect is often seen on the South Island. The wetter and cooler side of the mountains are usually the west side, and the drier and warmer side is the east side, areas such as Canterbury and Otago. Now, the same thing can occur in reverse if the winds are coming from the opposite direction. Now also, we shouldn't forget that New Zealand is not the only place where Foehn winds have a big effect on the weather. Perhaps the most dramatic example is Chile in the Atacama Desert. Now right next to the Atacama Desert are the Andes Mountains. And here, wind flowing over the top of the Andes from the east dry out to an extreme level. So luckily, Foehn winds don't create dangerous weather conditions for New Zealand, but they do affect our weather and you'll want to be prepared.
You can be better prepared for the outdoors with weather tips
from Weather Nerds.